Hi students, hope you all will be safe and healthy. Our today's topic is noun clause. As you know, we have already discussed different types of clauses. Clause is a group of words which consisted of a subject and a verb, and it gives us a complete sense. Then we have discussed that there are two main types of clauses: independent clause, which does not depend and depends on other words to complete its meaning and which gives us a whole complete meaning, and that could be also called a complete sentence. And dependent clause was another type of clause which depends on other words to complete its meaning and which always needed the main clause to complete its meaning. So here we are discussing noun clause. A noun clause is a subordinate clause used as a noun. Again, it's clear that we have discussed that we have different types of subordinate or dependent clauses, in which noun clause is one of them. A noun clause is a subordinate clause. It is a dependent clause. It is a type of dependent clause or subordinate clause used as a noun, but it acts or its function as a noun in a sentence. Like as an example, as we have discussed noun phrase. So same is the case with noun clause. It also function as a noun in a sentence. Like for example, what you have promised is acceptable. Here you can see what you have promised is acceptable. If we separated this part of the sentence, what you have proposed is acceptable. So here you can see what you, this word you is a subject here. Have is a helping verb and then proposed is a verb. So it consisting of a subject and a verb, and it is dependent on the rest of the sentence. Is again a verb, and acceptable is an adjective. So it means that this part of sentence is depending on the rest of the sentence. What you have proposed, so what is acceptable. So this part of the sentence is a noun clause. What you have proposed, what you have proposed is a noun clause here. Tell me what your marketing strategies are. So here you can see tell me. Here it is a separate part of a sentence, and then what your marketing strategies are. So what your marketing strategies are, this part of sentence is a noun clause here because it is functioning as a noun in this sentence. Let's discuss it. It would be always begins with such type of words. Noun clause begin with words such as how, that, what, whatever, when, where, whether, which, whichever, who, whoever, whom, whomever, and why. It means that all different types of question sentences, like as we use these words when or who or whom or which, what, so we use them for question sentences as well. So different types of question sentences which would be consisting of noun clause would be always, we can recognize them with these question words, WH words as well. Here you can see that a noun clause is used as a subject and a subject complement. How it can be used as a subject or a subject complement, you can see it in the examples. What you do in your free time is your business. So here you can see underlined part is the noun clause. What you do in your free time is your business. So here you can see this underlined part of the sentence is a noun clause. Why? Because it is functioning as a subject in this sentence. It is functioning as a noun in this sentence. As you can see that what you, so here you is the subject of this part of the sentence. Do is a verb here. And then again in the rest of the sentence is the verb here. So here you can see, if we just omitted this part of the sentence, what you do in your free time, and we just write it instead of it, of this part, instead of this part, we just write it, it is your business. So here we can recognize it that this part of the sentence is functioning as a subject in this sentence. What you do in your free time is your business. So here this part can be replaced with a noun or a pronoun as well. So it means that it is functioning as a subject of this sentence. Then again in the next one you can see Tom is not what you would call friendly. Here again you can see Tom is the subject and is a verb in that part of the sentence. And then look at the underlined part. You is the subject here and Carl is a main verb here. So here again you can see that this both the parts are consisting of different subject and verb. Tom is not what you would call friendly. So here you can see that what you would call friendly is a noun phrase and it is functioning as a subject complement here. Why? Because it is telling us about something about the subject, which is Tom. So like we can say Tom is not friendly. Instead of this whole noun phrase, we can just simply say that Tom is not friendly. But we have used this noun clause here. So it is acting as a subject complement here, because it is, you know, subject complement, when something, some any type of complement, any type of description is given about the subject, that is called subject complement. So Tom is subject here and this part of the underlined part of the sentence noun phrase is telling us about the subject Tom. So this part is noun phrase here, which is acting as a subject complement. Okay, then remember that what is used only in a noun clause. Like only a noun clause started with the word what. Adjective or adverb clause never started with the word what. Only noun clause started with the word what. As you can see in the above two examples that this noun clause started with the word what here. As an object, object of preposition and object of verb, a noun phrase can also be, a noun clause can also be used as an object, object of preposition or object of verb as well. As you can see, she said that she was sorry. Here, she was sorry is a, that she was sorry is a object here, but it is a noun phrase as well. Noun phrase is used as an object here. She said, what does she said? That she was sorry. So this underlined part is used as an object here. This that is enclosed in brackets because it may be omitted. Like if you just say that she said she was sorry, still the meaning would be clear. So this part of the sentence is a underlined part of the sentence is a noun clause which is used as an object here. Look at another one. I don't worry about what others think. Here again you can see what other things. It is the object of preposition here. It is used as an object of preposition here and it is a noun clause. I don't worry. So here you can see this part of sentence is also a separate clause and the rest of the sentence about what others think. It is a dependent clause. It is a noun phrase, noun clause which is depending on the main clause to complete its meaning. But here it is functioning as an object of preposition in it. I really want to believe that tomorrow will be better. Here again you can see here it is used as an object of verb. I really want to believe that tomorrow will be better. So you can see that I really want to believe here it is a main clause, that tomorrow will be better is a dependent clause, and it is a noun phrase, a noun clause, because it is functioning as an object here, object of verb. Why? Because it is modifying the verb believe here. To believe is an infinitive. Believe is a verb. 2 plus first form of verb is called infinitive. So believe is a verb which is modified by that tomorrow will be better. And look at the previous example. As it is started from the word about, which is a preposition, that's why we call it an object of preposition. Hope this lecture would be clear to you and you would recognize noun clause in a sentence very easily. Your homework for today is that you have to write 5 sentences which would be consisting of noun clauses in them. See you in my next class. Have a nice day. Bye bye.